good start.
Yeah,
up in the hill.
But is it recording?
It is recording, but I thought since we're still discussing, we can just have a discussion and then we start recording, so you don't have like a 50-minute video.
No, but we can cut it out. Okay. Now it's recording, right?
It is recording, yeah.
Okay. So, Michael, when we say PLCnext is an open platform, what do we mean by that?
Yeah, it's not too difficult to explain. So if you take a look to classical PLCs, it is a question of the system architecture. Mm-hmm. If you take a look to a classical PLC, you have on the bottom layer a normal operating system, a real-time operating system, and on that operating system, each PLC manufacturer has placed a proprietary runtime system case. And that is programmed by a vendor-specific programming tool.
So you need a specific software for when you want to program a PLC. You need a specific software that comes from the manufacturer.
Exactly.
Right?
That was a
closed
platform because there's no exchange of code between different PLC vendors possible. Only if you have fulfilled the minimum standard, you can copy structured text from one to another, but that is not really handy.
Okay, so that means that you need to program PLC A, and then you need a specific software for PLC A.
Exactly.
You need to program PLC B, you need a specific software for PLC B.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
That means closed platform.
Exactly, and that is a big difference to PLCnext technology. In PLCnext technology, we have decided to use on Linux as an operating system, and any programming tool can compile his code against the Linux operating system. So it is possible to program in Microsoft Visual Studio, Eclipse, or MATLAB Simulink so far. And this code will be directly compiled against the Linux, so it is also executable. And even if you program in PLCnext Engineer code in 6.11.31, it will be compiled against our runtime system, but the big difference is that our runtime system then will be an instance on based on the Linux. And each program has a new instance of our runtime system. At last, if you have programmed or have different programs coming from different languages, you have them placed onto the Linux system and each is program is running independently.
So this means that, for example, if I have an application that requires me to write something in ladder logic, I can use PLCnext Engineer, write that ladder logic part, put it in there. Now, based on my application, I need to write some code in C++.
Yeah.
Then I can write that C++ into whatever software that I can use. Or maybe you can give an example what software we can use for C++.
Microsoft Visual Studio. Eclipse.
So I can write my C++ program into Microsoft Visual Studio and then compile it, take that file and download it to PLCnext.
Exactly. And then you can configure it in PLCnext Engineer in our software, and you see it as a normal program. And the thing behind this, because I'm wondering why this question don't come up. If you have different programs, each program has to exchange process data with another program.
Yeah, yeah.
And for that, in PLCnext technology, we have implemented the so-called global data space, and that global data space makes it possible that each program can exchange process data together, even with a feed bus or with other systems.
And then when you say this global what? Global
data space.
But it's like a container that you can put a ladder logic program in it, and then you can put a Python program in it, a C++ program in it, and then these programs can communicate with each other. For example, in the ladder logic program can see what's going on in the C++ program, and then based on those, based on that program, it can, for example, open up a gate or something.
Yeah, exactly.
Right? They can communicate. And this is something that with other PLCs, it's not possible. With other PLCs, you can write a ladder logic, you can put it into the PLC, but it's not possible to write something, for example, in C++ or Python in another software and then download it into that PLC, right?
Exactly. The collaboration and the possibility to have different sources and different kind of programmers working on one platform, and these programs are able to be interconnected together. That is unique on PLCnext.
And that's what we call open platform. So open platform means that I can write something ladder logic, download it to PLCnext, and then I can go on my laptop in Visual Studio and then write something in C++ and then download it to PLCnext. I can write something in Python in a different software, not a specific software that is made for this PLC, whatever software, compile it, and then download it again to PLCnext. And this is what we mean by open.
Exactly.
Open platform, open PLC. That was really interesting for me. I think this is something that people also, maybe there are a lot of people like me that was like, okay, PLCnext is an open platform. Oh, that's good. But I didn't really know how this open platform. But now that Michael explained it like this, I'm like, oh, okay, this is open platform.
Yeah. Do you know that Johnny Depp takes 10 of those takes and you did it in one at once?
Yeah. Great. Yeah. Really good.
Yeah.
Good. I think this makes really good content for LinkedIn.